Good morning, everyone. It's really nice to finally meet all the people that we have known virtually. So in the community, we know everyone virtually, but finally we can meet. So I'm Nirab Pudasaini, and today I'm going to talk about the state of the map of Nepal. So we do not have 1,000 active daily contributors. I wish we had, but so the spike you see is because it was the screenshot that I took was during the flood. So we had a lot of international mappers helping as well. So the spike in the month of August you see is during the floods. They were flooding in the southern plains of Tarai. So people were mapping, and we had about 1,000 mappers then. But we usually have 40 mappers daily active. Mappers in Nepal, and you can see in the yearly chart, you can see that huge spike. That is the spike during the Nepal earthquake, of course, in 2015. So these are the numbers, and what I would like to do is I'd like to put faces to these numbers. So this is Marek. So he's one of he's from OSM Poland, but he regularly maps Nepal. We say he's half Nepali. And then we have local mappers as well. We have local mappers, the first generation of local mappers. So these were the initial champions, but these guys are falling behind now because there are like new generation of awesome mappers who are coming up and overtaking them. So I think I see a few of these faces in the crowd as well. So we are doing pretty good in terms of like generating interest of new generation as well. And if you see the trend of like node creation and deletion, it is similar to the activity of daily contributors as well. And let me show you. So you guys may have already like checked out the maps of Kathmandu because you are using it for navigation here. But let me show you a few other places in Nepal and how they have been mapped. So this is Kathmandu Basin. So this is a huge river, and there are like 70 communities that are in risk due to flooding. So this place was not mapped, and in one of the projects with practical action, so this place is now very detailedly mapped. So all the communities, all the houses, all the land use data has been put to the map, and you can see the contrast. So it is pretty amazing. So another place is Pokhara. So we have an active project, the secondary cities project. So we have a session about the secondary cities project as well. So if you are interested, you can go and visit there. So Pokhara has been pretty detailed map, and the interesting thing about Pokhara is we are also partnering with the local government in Pokhara, and we are also we have mapped all the schools, all the hospitals, and all the financial institutions in Pokhara. So, and another is, so I talked about the flooding in the southern Tarai, and this is one of the places, Inarwa, this was the condition there of map before the flooding. So, and after the flooding, the people started contributing, and this is what they produced. So this is also pretty amazing. So another project is, I showed you the half Nepali guy, Marek. So he's pretty active, and he's like, he keeps us quite busy. And so we have this one project where we engage the remote mappers. It is called Project Ilam. And they have been mapping Ilam, and this is what they have been able to do till now. So, talking about like who are working in OSM Nepal. So of course Kathmandu Living Labs is the major institution working in Kathmandu in Nepal. But then slowly other organizations has also like started joining in the movement. So there are like practical action, WFP. So World Food Program Nepal recently conducted a pre-conference mapathon in Isimor, and they were pretty amazed to see like there were like 20,000 building mapped in one event. So there were 75 mappers and they mapped in one day, they mapped 20,000 buildings. And one of the GIS guy from WFP Nepal told me like, this will take us 4 months to do. So if we go and if you do accordingly, mapping 20,000 buildings will take us 4 months. And we were able to do this in just one day. So he was pretty amazed with that. Of course, there is the part of like data validation and field verification, but still, so we have new organizations joining. And we have also been able to like sensitize few of the local government agencies. So there are municipalities like Nilkantha, Pokhara, and Budhanilkantha. And they have been starting to use OpenStreetMap in their work. There are youth groups like GSAN, Geomatics Engineering Society of Nepal, and there is a mapping chapter, youth mapping chapter in the Institute of Crisis Management. They are also pretty active now and working. And there are, of course, university and colleges are also working in OpenStreetMap in Nepal. So major events and activities. So we conduct a lot of events. So it won't be like possible for me to cover all the events, but I'll just give you a highlight of like the major activities that happened in the previous year. So of course, one is the secondary series Pokhara. If you go and look at the map of Pokhara, it is pretty detailed and it is a map that we are proud of. And one of the reasons is we have an active secondary cities project going on there. Another is we did a course on civic learning. Students from high school of Kathmandu, they combined mapping along with civic learning and they learned about OpenStreetMap. So there is also a session today going on. There is Mona Bhattrai. She's talking about this experience as well. So if you are interested, you can go and join in there as well. We work with business students of King's College, MBA students, and we did community asset mapping. So this was also pretty interesting for them because they used to think, business students, they do not think in terms of geospatial data. So this course was pretty new and informational to them. And we have this program called Digital Internship in which we hire university students and we train them to map in OpenStreetMap. It's a three-month-long program and they learn about OpenStreetMap and various other leadership skills as well. And then we organized the first ever Youth Mappers workshop here in this same hotel and it was pretty amazing as well. So the project I showed you, the Karnali basin mapping, that is also the project of last year. And we are also working in Dhading, municipality of Nilkantha, to map the municipality of Nilkantha. So, and of course, there is we are the host country of SotM-Asia as well. So this is also one of the major events that happened in Nepal this year. So this is a very interesting slide because this shows how the government is taking OpenStreetMap. So you can see this is the National Mapping Agency of Nepal Survey Department, and what they have done is they have put a slider image. This is not an interactive map. They have put a slider image in their site. So what I think as a mapper is that government now realizes that there is a value, there is a utility in OpenStreetMap, but they are yet in confusion to whether to invest or whether not to invest their efforts into this map. So they are in this thinking phase and then maybe we'll soon be able to like prompt action from them as well. But we have been able to like prompt action from few other government agencies. One of them is Pokhara Municipality. So Pokhara Municipality published a map book. So from the data that was created in OpenStreetMap, they made a map book. They printed 500 copies of this map book and distributed it. And they were helped by Kathmandu Living Labs and the students of the Western Regional Campus as well. So this is one of the initiatives. And there are like various visible use of OpenStreetMap that we see around in Nepal. So this is one of the UNESCO heritage site, and if you go to this Budhanilkantha stupa, and if you go to Budhanilkantha stupa, you can see a big map there, and this map was made using OpenStreetMap data. So there are similar kind of maps like in Pokhara municipality. If you go to Pokhara municipality office, you see like outside of the Pokhara municipality office, you see a big printed map that uses OpenStreetMap data. So there are a lot of feasible use of OpenStreetMap data, and what that does is that inspires local mappers. So this is Nikesh, and when he learned about OpenStreetMap, he went to his home, he mapped his hometown area, and then he printed out with the help of his youth club, he printed out the map and then posted it in his youth club. So that inspires the mapper, and then we also get international recognition. Our mappers are also getting international recognition as well. So this is Gaurav Thapa, he was mapper of the month of August. So he was the worldwide mapper of the month. And we have a lot of challenges and opportunity. It is quite similar to all the like other country presenters. So it was we need to like engage more private sector. We have a problem with localization, both in terms of language and also in terms of like tagging and standardization. And we also need to do a lot of documentation regarding country specific tags. And we also have problem retaining mappers. So we have almost reached out to like 5,000 mappers, but maybe like we are still able to get only 40 daily active users. So we need to think about like retaining this mapper, and we also need to work together with the government. And this thing is, I see these as challenges and both also as an opportunity to go forward. And that's why I say like keep calm and map it OpenStreetMap. Thank you.